What experiences shaped my wanting to be on the CCE board? I think that my being in counselor education and ultimately wanting to be and applying to be on the CCE board is in my genes. I come from a family of educators. Both my parents were teachers. My father started a school. I'm the youngest of eight, and many of my older brothers and sisters are educators. And some of them are also having advanced degrees in counseling and mental health. So I think between the education part of my background and the mental health counseling side of my background, counselor education was the perfect fit for me. I've been teaching since 1995, and almost all of those years have been in programs that are counseling related. I have a terrific position as a counselor educator. And I often tell students that because I consider myself very lucky in terms of what I do. I work with fantastic colleagues. I work with fantastic students who are motivated, who are wanting to change the world and wanting to help other people. And I get paid to learn. I get paid to research. I get paid to find out about things in terms of the counseling domain. So I love what I do. And I've been at Indiana University of Pennsylvania since 2001. The opportunity to apply for the board for CCE was something that I definitely wanted to do. And once I saw the notice, I said, I'm going to do that. I wanted to give more to the profession. And I saw this opportunity to apply to be on the CCE board as a wonderful one. And the experience has been extremely positive. It also dovetails with one of my strong emphases in counselor education, and that is professional development. I want students in counselor education and in counseling to think about professional development at the outset of their program and not when the program finishes. So at Indiana University of Pennsylvania, I direct the Center for Counselor Training and Services. We bring in nationally known people in the counseling profession for one-day workshops for students, for alumni, for area counselors and mental health professionals. And it's also been that focus of professional development, continuing education, that sparked my interest in terms of wanting to be on the board for the Center for Credentialing and Education. So I think it's a combination of my background in terms of my family, in terms of my desire to be a counselor educator, and the emphasis in terms of professional development, continuing education, that have prompted me to wanting to be a part of the Center for Credentialing and Education. Why is the foundation a good partner for the foundation? I've been on the CCE board since 2007. And the decision for CCE to be a supporter of the foundation goes back before me. I have to say, I'm very glad they made that decision. I personally see a wonderful fit for what the Center for Credentialing and Education does as its mission and the NBCC Foundation. The Center for Credentialing and Education has a variety of services. And for more than 10 years now, they have been in the area of management services, of credentialing, of testing and assessment, both domestically and internationally. What the NBCC Foundation does parallels in terms of their efforts and in terms of their motivations to support the endeavors of the counseling profession, both here and worldwide. So I see a natural fit there in terms of what the foundation is doing, the exciting things that they're doing, and what the Center for Credentialing and Education does. Why are the scholarships of the foundation important? I could talk about that for hours. As a counselor educator, I sometimes say to my students, you know, I was in graduate school for 16,000 years, and I know exactly what it's like to be in graduate school. Well, I thought about that recently, and the fact is that no, I don't. what I mean to say here is that I think being in graduate school today is even more difficult. And I think it's made more difficult by rising tuition, rising gas prices in terms of commutes back and forth, and there's always textbooks, and there's always the juggling with maybe part-time jobs, families, relationships. That's difficult. So for students today to decide to go into a graduate degree, a graduate program in counseling, I tip my hat. I applaud them. I think that they're heroes in life. It's not easy. The scholarships make a huge difference. And what the NBCC Foundation is doing in terms of offering these scholarships, I think is absolutely wonderful. It's also a matter of what the NBCC Foundation is choosing as far as its emphases with military and rural areas. I teach at Indiana University of Pennsylvania. It's in a rural area. So the whole notion of serving rural communities is near and dear in terms of what I see every day in the classroom. I have students making commutes of 45 minutes, 60 minutes, 90 minutes. That's one way. So I applaud what the NBCC Foundation is doing, not only in terms of offering scholarships to students who are going to be the emerging leaders in the counseling profession, but also in terms of the emphases with the rural and military. And that's why I think the scholarships are so vital to the future of the counseling profession. The community capacity program, I think, is a vital part to what I think the NBCC Foundation is doing so very well. Let's talk about the mental health facilitator program. It's a brilliant idea. There are nearly 7 billion people in this world. Now, if you take away the U.S. population of about 307 million, we're talking about 6.7 billion people living outside of the United States. Regardless of the kind of passport that a person's carrying, regardless of his or her nationality, mental health services are so important. And the whole notion of getting to those people who are underserved or non-served and with mental health services, I think, is so important. Not only today, but it's going to be as important and more important in the coming years to come, in the coming decades. What I also appreciated about the mental health program is that it is culturally sensitive. I think that's so important in terms of delivering services, especially mental health, outside of the United States. So I applaud and I appreciate the sensitivity to cultures. When I think about the components of the mental health facilitator program, I think it's right on target. First of all, it's 30 hours. It's not a 3-hour, 6-hour program. It's extensive and it's comprehensive. And I think that that's a large takeaway for whoever goes through the mental health facilitator program. Second, I also applaud and appreciate the components, meaning helping skills, trauma response, suicide prevention, referral, consultation. Those are excellent components to include in any kind of program, regardless of where it is, and again, being delivered in a culturally sensitive, appropriate manner. Those are reasons why I'm very excited about the mental health facilitator program. And I think that there are only positive things that are going to come out of that. Why does the counseling profession need the NBCC Foundation? The heart of the counseling profession is beneficence, doing good. And as I see it, that's exactly what the heart of the NBCC Foundation is, bringing good to people. And it could be bringing good to people through scholarships. It could be bringing good to people through the MHF program. But the bottom line is that it's bringing good to people. I'm also reminded of the story of Johnny Appleseed, walking through the fields, planting seeds, and moving on. Now, he never saw the fruits of his matured trees, but he planted seeds. And I think that that's a large part of not only what the counseling profession is all about, but also about the NBCC Foundation. You are planting seeds. Now, these scholarships are absolutely fantastic, not only because there's not just one or two, but there are many of them, and they're $3,000. That's a hefty amount of money for a graduate student. I think that's absolutely fantastic. These are large seeds. And in terms of the counseling profession, sometimes I hear students say, oh, you know, I'm in a practicum, I'm in a field experience, I don't know if I'm making a difference. Sometimes as counselors, we don't know the immediate effects of the differences that we're making in people's lives. The NBCC Foundation is bringing goodness to students. It's bringing goodness to people through the MHF program in various ways. And one of the things that I'm fascinated by is that what will these seeds grow to be? So, for instance, the people who have gotten the scholarships, they're going to be the emerging leaders in our counseling profession. And it's the NBCC Foundation scholarships that are going to help them in terms of getting through grad school financially, but also in terms of they're going to look back and say, wow, that was a fantastic scholarship. I really got a lot out of that. They're going to be the emerging leaders of our profession. It's a win-win situation. And with people in the mental health facilitator program, who knows about the thousands and perhaps millions of lives that are going to be touched by that program? Because think about the training that goes out to lay people, paraprofessionals, mental health professionals, and how they're going to be taking that out into their communities and touching life after life after life after life. The thing about counseling is that professional counselors touch people's lives in a multitude of ways. It's not just the direct counseling, and whether that be individual counseling, group counseling, couples counseling, group work. It's not just that. It's about public policy. It's about consultation. It's about outreach. It's about advocacy. And when I think about what the tentacles are of what the NBCC Foundation programs are going to do and are doing now, it's very exciting. And that's why I think that the counseling profession needs and merits and benefits by the NBCC Foundation. People in this country get letters every day from very worthwhile causes. For me personally, the NBCC Foundation is always going to be at the top of my list. The NBCC Foundation, as I see it, is changing the world. And it can go back to the planting seeds through the scholarships. It can go back to the notion of planting seeds through the mental health facilitator program. It's changing the world. Counselors touch lives, and whether it's through direct care, indirect care, collaboration, a multitude of different ways, the NBCC Foundation is touching the profession in very positive ways. And as a result of that, only good things can come out of that. As a result, I think that the NBCC Foundation is a very worthwhile choice in terms of who are you going to support? What organizations are you going to support? For me, it's an easy answer. So what hopes do I have for the NBCC Foundation? I have several. And the reason I have several is because I see a world of potential in the future of the NBCC Foundation. There's a wonderful line in the NBCC Foundation website, which to me really captures the heart of everything: strategically focusing resources for positive change. That's, to me, the essence of what I hope the NBCC Foundation continues to do. So if I had a crystal ball and I were looking in the future and going back to the question of what do I hope for the MBCC Foundation, I would hope to see stories such as NBCC scholarships have now been given to counseling students in all 50 states. I would love to see empirical research to support the effectiveness of the MHF program. When I look into my crystal ball, I would love to see stories about bringing the mental health facilitator program into corporations in this country. And not just corporations, but communities. Because I see tremendous value in that program, whether it's in Bhutan, Malawi, or North Carolina. I see tremendous value in people knowing about mental health facilitation, about getting people the help that they so deserve. And that's another thing. Many people seek counseling, but many people do not. And with the Mental Health Facilitation Program, my hope is that starts to slowly but surely alleviate the stigma that can surround seeking counseling. And it also, I hope to see people knowing more about even basic mental health facilitation skills. Because my hope is that if they know more, the stigma goes away. And wouldn't that be a wonderful world? My hope for the NBCC Foundation is to see it not just in the countries where it's been, but to go to other countries, wherever that may be. Again, delivered in a culturally sensitive way that's at the foundation of that whole program. My hope for the NBCC Foundation is to see an expansive board of visitors, where maybe one day I could be on that board personally and have other people know about the exciting things that the NBCC Foundation does and about the changes and impact that it has, not only just on the counseling profession, but it's on people's lives. And that's my hope for the NBCC Foundation.